heartburn, that's all. But anyways, okay, I will.
The Packer fans.
Well, first of all, don't you think that Thurman looks kind of like Jesus Christ?
Yes, I did say that
And
to
maybe that gets
Bucho.
to Pacquiao's head. I think he did say that.
That Well, I didn't think about that, but yeah,
Maybe, yeah.
it's true. I
He should
mean,
have
that's
straightened out his hair on he should have straightened out his hair on the way in and wore like a robe and some sandals. And then on the stare down, maybe that he would have got to Thurman's head. Because I ain't gonna beat up on Jesus Christ.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Me and my friend were walking down Newport Beach, and we were drinking, and he ran into Christopher Walken. Like he bumped him on the chest. He bumped
Did he
chest.
say,
He was with.
give me more of that cowbell?
Now he started talking shit to him. He's like, "Hey, what?" But then later he realized, "Oh, that's fucking Christopher Walken." And we're like, "Oh yeah, that was, huh?" I got my
Man.
rides right there. I got my cars here in the Philippines, some Fords, some old school cars. I'm taking up drawing. I'm taking up drawing. I got my drawing books, my sketch pads. Yeah, look, when I look, you know how they say he's got these big ass ink? Obviously, he's got these big ass fucking cankles, right? Manny Pacquiao.
Yeah.
Look, this is kind of weird, but it's the truth. I'm just gonna say, like, as a boxing fucking fan, I came all the way out to the Philippines. I tracked them down. I found them at a good time where I was alone with them talking. And then when I took the picture and I shook his hand, look, I let my arm totally go like limp, so I can hold his hand and fucking feel like I just want to. I closed my eyes too. I want to see how heavy his hand was. His hand is heavy. Just compare the extremities of his body, how he got them cankles. He's got them fucking big ass hands for his body size. Just think of the head also. That's another motherfucker's got heavy hands. I'm telling you.
Durant had
fucking badass, man.
Underestimated footwork, man. Underestimated.
Well,
Like what you
but
just
you
said
know
right
what?
there.
You know what recognize? You know what recognize? You're
Yeah.
fucking spot on.
Ow.
You know, that's one thing that I don't know if Pacquiao, when he got knocked out by Marquez, and I'm not an expert. I mean, I've been dropped myself, you know, knocked out before, but that's a different story. I can explain that, how that happened. Although I have a good chin. Anyhow, that was in a street fight. Anyways, this motherfucker, no, not this fight. Well,
Whoa.
Payano got dropped, but Pacquiao, when he got dropped, I think he went out of consciousness to like where he woke up, that he almost didn't realize the pain that he might have gone through if he would have been
Yeah,
like, yeah.
it's
damn,
kind of
I
like
missed that.
when you go for a surgery, you're under the anesthetic, so you cannot feel anything.
Oh, wow, you're a genius because I didn't think of that, but it kind
Yeah.
of correlates to my thinking. Because like 3 years ago, I got into a little scuffle I didn't want to talk about earlier because I'm not the one to kind of like boast about because it's not really to boast about. I found some guy's ID in the street, then some guy invited me to some beers. I had some troubles with my old lady at the time that I had, and I knocked out this guy that was about 6 foot 4, and he was like about 260 pounds, honestly, maybe even bigger. And I KO'd him and I knocked him out. Because he was putting me in a dangerous situation to where I had to hit him with my left hand and I knocked him out cold. Then after, like later when he woke up, he got some African guys that were like that immigrated to San Diego and they kind of chased me down. And well, that's not the point of the story. I knocked this guy out, but what you usually hurt in your hand is your thumb. When you're not when you don't that's why in bare knuckle, they have these little like they have these wraps where your knuckles are like flat and uncovered, but then the thumb is also semi-protected because that little bone on the top, you know, that's what you will hurt. One thing I have to say, I don't mean to cut your train of
Come
thought. I'm kind of glad that the revolution is here and he's awake. And even though he's tired, has been up like for 3 days, even you, Stu, that you're coming off of the back burner and a
Yeah,
3 day hiatus. This is
I'm not
history.
fighting. I don't have any
This is
Gonzalo.
history. Pacquiao's gonna be in a tough fight. Yeah,
Calm down, man. Fucking out.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Hey,
Thanks,
I'm
Gonzalo.
ready for that. I think he's on
Are
that
you wasted?
Calvin Lewis juice.
Yeah.
Are you wasted, Gonzalo?
Hey, who is this? Is this Pete all of a sudden speaking after being silent for 1 week? No, I'm not wasted. But what I'm saying, Pacquiao, the bright lights are on, and your boy Keith Thurman is gonna get exposed. Exposed.
Holy
Gonzalo
shit.
off of that tandoori. Gonzalo drinking
Hey,
that tandoori.
that tandoori, hey, Revolution, you better be awake because you're gonna miss history. And you,
I
Pete,
would like to be
my
a true
boy, hey,
brain.
check it out. Hey, Pacquiao, this is like an earthquake that shifts from side to side. And Pacquiao's an earthquake that moves up and down. That's why I think I changed my prediction all of a sudden to a 10-round KO because this is a collision course. Pacquiao moves up and down, in other words, from midtown to front town. from downtown to Front Street. He throws from his shoulder. He can throw a left straight to Front Street, you know, to outside.
Outside.
So he's moving forward like an earthquake that moves up and down. And Thurman, he's like the earthquake that shifts from side to side. So at any point in time, they're going to cross paths. They're going to collide in a collision course. But I think the guy that's faster is going to get there a little bit quicker.
Gonzalo, the only reason I asked if you were drunk is because earlier I had my mic muted and earlier you fucking went off because Revolution's watching the fight. That's all. I was just joking around.
No. Yeah, but it's just you've been quiet out ever since, like a few podcasts, and you
can talk over you. Who can fucking get a word in?
You're from Florida, and Thurman's from Florida, which is not a bad. Yeah. I'm not criticizing. I'm just saying.
I don't give a fuck.
Thurman threw his shot that he was gonna throw all night, and Pacquiao just left it off. That was probably the best. Oh, he's down. Yes, Manny Pacquiao. His job keeps fucking Thurman. The great Manny Pacquiao.
I'm tuning off, guys. I'm tuning off. I want to watch it live. You just
don't play. Don't play with a man at his pace. Don't play with a man at his pace.
Fuck my streaming.
All I gotta say.
The great Manny Pacquiao. He's got he's walking side to side. Manny Pacquiao. The right hand's not gonna be affected. Because Manny Pacquiao's a guy that loves his forward, he cannot counter that. Like Stu said, he's jumping on the tip of his feet. How's he going to tie
fucking Pacquiao? Stu, go listen to that punch when it landed. Just listen to the punch. Because because Deontay Wilder doesn't have the foundations in the bottom. He wouldn't be able to come back from that. To Anthony Joshua's credit, even though we kind of get on him with the big muscles, to his credit, he got the foundations. He got the legs to come back. Because if you look, that was it has like this bulldozer effect. Just picture a bomb blowing up from the top and going all the way down. That's what happened.
Like the Twin Towers?
Yeah.
Whoa. What is all that?
Yeah.
Fucked up, bro.
9/11. Recognize. New York. 9/11. Recognize New York.